I was pretty confident at the age of 16 that I was going to do something special with cricket one day. We had this belief in the family to always keep our feet on the ground. In my case, the first 20 years of my life, it was my parents and my two older brothers. They're 6 and 9 years older than me, respectively, so I always had to really perform above my ability to compete with them. From a very young age, from the age of 4 or 5, I could compete and sort of held my own in most sports in the backyard. Momentum is a funny thing. It comes and goes, and it's a matter of really maximizing those moments when you do have the momentum behind you. Even though cricket is a team sport, it can be very lonely at times. At the end of the day, you've got to reach a certain level of individual brilliance to maintain your spot in the team, to feel like you're going somewhere with your career. So as a professional athlete, I've had my coaches and mentors who have always been supportive to help me to get that momentum on my side again when I didn't have it. But at the end of the day, you're alone when you walk across that boundary. It's a mental thing where you really got to push yourself. Once you make that mental switch, you get a bit of momentum. It becomes a bit easier. The funny thing is, you're never that far away. It's always closer than you think. It feels like it's a million miles away. My first Test 100, my first ODI 100, I never felt that it was going to happen. Until that happened, I realized I was always so close, and then it just started flowing and it became a lot easier.